हेलो, माई सेल्फ विवेक जामवाल, टीम मेंबर फ्रॉम लेक्सिसेंस कंपनी, एंड माई टूडेज टॉपिक इज सेडिशन। एवरी सिटीजन हैज बीन गिवन फ्रीडम टू स्पीक एंड एक्सप्रेस देयर व्यूज अंडर आर्टिकल 19(1)(a) ऑफ द इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन। हाउएवर, दिस फ्रीडम इज नॉट एब्सोल्यूट एंड सम रीजनेबल रिस्ट्रिक्शंस हैव बीन इम्पोज ऑन फ्रीडम ऑफ स्पीच एंड एक्सप्रेशन अंडर आर्टिकल 19(2). But when a person does an act by his words or by speech or through some signs or representation which is held to be contemptuous towards the government of India, then such act is punishable under Section 124A of Indian Penal Code 1860. Sedition is an offense that criminalizes speech that is regarded to be disloyal or too threatening to the state. This means that If any person recites or incites a large number of people towards against the state, then he will be charged against sedition. That is Article 124A of IPC 1860. The provision of Section 124A is very wide, and it covers the act of defamation of central government, of government, excluding any criticism in good faith of any particular measures of act of administration. Now let's begin the study of law of sedition. The term sedition means conduct or speech which results in mutiny against the authority of state. Law of sedition deals with Section 124A of Indian Penal Code 1860, is considered as a reasonable restrictions on freedom of speech. It means that a sedition is a reasonable restrictions on freedom of speech, because we cannot give absolute freedom of speech to everyone. There must be some restriction, needs to be restrictions. As a human beings, we will try to exploit the right. We will defame, we will incite people against the state. So we need a law, and that law is law of sedition under Article 124A of IPC 1860. It was drafted by Thomas Macaulay and introduced in 1870. Now it means law of sedition is introduced by Lord Macaulay in 1870. The following point describe the origin of sedition law. One is, first, origin of sedition law in India is connected to Wahhabist movement of 19th century. This was an Islamic revivalist movement and was led by Syed Ahmed Bareilly. Since 1830, the movement was active, but in the wake of 1857 revolt, it turned into armed resistance, a jihad against the British. The British termed Wahhabis as rebels and carried out military operations against the Wahhabis. History of this law. In British era, sedition, Section 124A was not a part of Indian Penal Code 1860, but this section was inserted into IPC by the IPC Amendment Act 1870. By an amending act of 1898, this provision was later replaced by Section 124A. According to the British law, under old IPC, exciting or attempting to excite feelings or disaffection was considered as sedition. Now the meaning of sedition under 124A of IPC 1860. Whoever by words, either spoken or written, or by signs, or by visible representations, or otherwise, brings or attempts to bring into hatred or contempt, or excites or attempts to excite disaffection towards a government, shall be punishable with life imprisonment. Explanation 1 to the sedition defines the scope of disaffection, and in explanation 2 and 3 indicates what under the English law is not considered seditious intention. What are the activities that are seditious in nature? In India, what constitutes as sedition is highly debated, as the Indian Penal Code for an act is called seditious. It should have the following components. First, any words which is can be either written or spoken, or signs which include placards, posters, or visible representation, must bring hatred, contempt, disaffection against the Indian government, must result in imminent violence or public disorder. As per the interpretation of the court on section 124A of Indian Penal Code 1860, the following acts have been considered as seditious. First, raising of slogans against the government. Example, Khalistan Zindabad by groups. Raising of slogans by individuals casually once or twice was held to be seditious. Second, a speech made by a person must incite violence, public disorder for it to be considered as seditious. Subsequent cases have gone to further interpret it to include incitement of imminent violence. Third, any written work which includes violence and disorder, public disorder. Seditious found in other laws. First, Indian Penal Code 1860, Section 124A. Second, the Code of Criminal Procedure 1973, Section 95. Third, the Unlawful Activities Prevention Act, Section 2, Clause 3. How legal mechanism sets in motion. Sedition is considered as high valuable crime in this Indian Penal Code, which is against the sovereignty of the country. It is cognizable offense which allows arrest without a warrant and police can start the investigation without the permission of court. There are some legal procedures regarding the charge of sedition. First, go to judicial police stations, lodging an FIR, then investigation, then charge sheet, then so on. Now, sedition as disloyalty in action. Sedition has been described as disloyalty in action. The object of sedition law is to introduce this content and insurrection and stir up opposition to government and bring the administration of justice into contempt. Sedition is a crime against the society as it involves all those practices that result in conduct disturbance in the state or lead to civil war, which contempt the sovereign and promotes public disorder. Defenses available to person charged with sedition. To get the explanation from criminal liability, the following are the defenses. First are that he did not make the sign or representation or not speak or write words or not any content, any act in the question. Second, he did not attempt into the contempt or attempt to disaffection. Third, such disaffection should not be towards the government. This simply means that he did not have any intention to promote disaffection or to create public disorder. Then he can go for defenses against the sedition. Sedition and Article 19(1)(a) of the Indian Constitution. The concept of free speech and attained global importance and all has supported it as a basic fundamental right of human being. In India, such rights are provided under Part 3rd and Article 19 of the Indian Constitution. So, as a conclusion, we can say that sedition is under Article 124, Clause A of IPC 1860. We can simply state that sedition is as a barrier towards freedom of speech, but it is also as important so that there should be public order, there should be maintenance of public order so that no one will violate the order and public disorder. So seditions need to be there and no one will incite peoples against the state. Thank you.